Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we will see if this DSX80 desoldering tool, this is part of this WR3M rework station, if it is not working, how we can troubleshoot it. It is a question from my viewer. I have problem in my rework station WR3M. Rework station blower is working nicely. What is blower? That is hot air gun. It is working nicely. It blows air. But desolder gun is not working. When we want to desolder, when we press this button, it must suck the air. It must create vacuum and it will suck the solder. He said there is no jam in the glass chamber. Okay. Even if the glass chamber it is jammed, it will give red LED. We will see now. He said please make a video about troubleshooting. We can see it have three channels. 1, 2, 3. This is soldering iron. Here is desoldering gun. This is vacuum and this is air. In my case, it is working. In the first step, to verify it, the electronic control we will remove from here and we will connect to any one channel. We can connect to 1 or 3. Install it here. If it is working, you can see when I will press this button, it will create vacuum. If there is no obstruction, it will give green light. And if I will press this button and I will close this, it will give red LED. That means vacuum line is now choke. If it works normally, that means we have problem in the controller. That time we need to troubleshoot the circuit card inside. At channel 2, first it was the solder gun, now I connected the soldering iron. It started to heat up. When it is pressed in, it is off now. That means our channel is working. If it is not working here, not working here, but the second device, it is working on the same channel where this desoldering tool was connected, how we can troubleshoot? This pin and this pin. Set multimeter to ohms. From the cut right side, these two pins. Here is heating element. Here it will provide 6.8 ohms. Now check resistance right side from the guide pin and the center pin. It is 44 kilo ohm. Press this button. It will go to zero. That means this switch is operative. If it is not going to zero, we can replace this micro switch that is in the grip. Just remove screws from here and pull it out. This switch, desolder from this point, this is 44 kilo ohm resistor here. Replace this switch and it is very easily available from the electronic spares store. If the heater is not giving resistance, that time we need to replace this complete desoldering tool. Then we can check resistance between, this is guide, first two for heater, this pin and this pin. It will give the sensor resistor. This resistance may be vary because it is now heat up. This resistance might be less or up. It must give resistance. Then we can connect the first pin in the left side to the guide. This is guide index left pin. Check resistance with the body. It is 0 ohm. If this resistance is okay, that time this tool must work. If it is not working here, you can check on the other channel. It must work. If it is not working, that time you need to troubleshoot the machine inside the controller. This time I'm not going to open my device because it is functional. These two pins, approximately 6.2 ohms, 7 ohms resistor. Then the other two pins, second two pins, this is sensor for the temperature sensor. This pin and the center pin, it is vacuum switch from here and center, here to here heater, here to here sensor. I hope this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.